This video caught my interest yesterday. I was scrolling through YouTube and I was like, fuck it, bro. Guy with sword versus 50 cops. This could not end well.
The date is April 3rd, 1997, and in the city of Seattle, Washington, at around 11 a.m., 911 operators would receive a call that would change the course of history.
Hello, 911, what's your emergency?
There's a black man. He's carrying something that looks like a samurai sword.
Okay, calm down. Please don't racial profile. Does he appear to be dangerous?
They saw a black man. What do they mean, don't racial profile? He saw a black man.
Standing there, but everyone's freaking out.
What is your current location?
Second and Pike.
Okay, I want you to stay on the line. I'm going to alert law enforcement of the situation.
Just send help now, please.
Is that Deku, bro?
This call triggered an 11-hour standoff, which would forever immortalize the name of the Seattle Street Samurai.
Bro thinks he's fucking Blade, bro. Bro watched one too many Marvel movies, bro, and now he thinks he can live his life as Blade, bro. Hey, Loki Aura, I'm not- Hey, hold on, bro. Loki Aura.
The man refuses to surrender his weapon without a fight.
There's talks about this guy online, but they're from forever ago.
And of course, Blade shows.
A contribution by putting this amazing story in a digestible video format. I was genuinely floored to see that nobody had made a video about this. Because this is insane. With nothing but sunglasses and a samurai sword to his name, this man held off an army of police officers for 11 hours. He withstood everything from getting shot to receiving a bribe in the form of a Big Mac.
So they were actually shooting this nigga and did he actually try to like deflect the shit
from getting shot to receiving a bribe in the form of a Big Mac and just stood there. His name is Tony Allison, but on this day he insisted that everybody, including the police, refer to him as Apollo. And it all started with him
Apollo
doing nothing. Yeah, it didn't actually start with that 911 call. That was fake.
Wow.
It was actually an off-duty.
Wow, so this nigga just, first he already got us with the clickbait, then he gonna clickbait us again with the video editing. Are we serious? Never trust anything you see online, bro.
The police officer, and he was alerted about a man in camo pants and a leather jacket that was quote-unquote disturbing. So this off-duty police officer decides to follow him from Pike's Place Market to the corner of 2nd and Pike. Bro, you're off-duty. Ryhard Monk.
Yeah, nah. That's crazy, bro. The fact that you're off duty and you're still trying to fucking be Batman is insane work, bro.
You see him in the video. Now, Apollo was suspicious of this guy following him, and rightfully so. I would be as well. So he took what the cop describes as a defensive stance with his sword at the ready, which is understandable in a defense situation.
Can you even walk outside with, like, a sword, bro? Like, do you need a license to carry a sword out in public? Like, is that an actual thing? So shooting at bro didn't work, so they thought a Big Mac would. That's the same.
Situation like this one. Sadly, that was enough for the off-duty cop to call his buddies. And they would remain in that same location for the next 11 hours. They closed all the stores, evacuated everybody, shut down all the streets, caused traffic jams. In case you guys are wondering whether he's actually dangerous with a sword, the news report made sure to seek out a trustworthy source.
So the man confirms authorities' worst fears.
Yeah, he knows how to use the sword.
When the cops...
That gotta be Cat, bruh. They asked a random ass bystander if they knew, bro. And they were just like, yo, this is my fucking 5 seconds of fame. Let me just say yes. Like, bro, he does not know him, man.
Got there. Apparently, they tried to bribe the samurai sword out of his hand with a glorious sum of... $50. I want you to take one look at this.
Hey, bruh. Put the sword down, and we'll give you $50. What the fuck?
I guess how he responded.
Defensive stance.
No, but actually, verbally, yo! You take one look at this guy and guess how he responded.
Defensive stance.
No, but actually, verbally, no he didn't way. Say... anything.
Ew,
the entire 11-hour standoff, except mentioning he had brothers in China and Russia, and correcting police officers when they wouldn't refer to him as Apollo. He also said that he was possessed by demons and wanted to kill them.
This nigga deadass thinks he's fucking Blade, bro! Nigga, be yourself!
He talked about Satan, he talked about his brothers in Russia and China, but he never really engaged.
Bro, this is cosplaying before cosplaying was even a fucking thing, bro. Bro, wow.
Negotiated.
But yeah, he just refused to drop the sword. I don't know, I couldn't imagine why. However, the police did not give up here. Nah, they went back to the drawing board and came up with another offer. Nah, I can't make this
It's your McDonald's Big Mac, you've got a taste.
They offered him a Big Mac. No, I'm serious, this is real. They offered him McDonald's.
This is targeted.
And they assumed since he was unmoved by this.
Nah, bro, that's not real, bro. Fucking black guy with sword, 11-hour standoff. They tempted him with a Big Mac. They dead ass said, yo, put the sword down and we'll give you a Big Mac. So when niggas be doing that shit, you know when they be playing good cop, bad cop in the investigation rooms, they really be bribing niggas like that? That's crazy.
He must have a mental health history. So they tried triggering schizophrenic urges. Of course, he was unmoved by these childish tricks and continued to stand his ground. So the police weren't sure what to do next. Since he wasn't attacking anybody, they had to get the sword out of his hand. They thought about throwing a net over him. They shot him with tranquilizer darts, which had no effect. They also shot him with those riot pellets, those little bean bags. Now, I don't know if you guys remember that scene in Jackass where they shot Johnny Knoxville with one of these things.
It's considered less lethal.
He was on the ground panting for like 20 minutes.
Looks like he got shot in his nuts.
Anyways, two unfair nut shots later, he was still standing.
But he endures round after round and shows no sign of surrender.
So then they decide
this nigga deadass is fucking trying to deflect the bullets and shit, bro. Bro got shot and immediately got into a defensive stance. That's crazy. And bro didn't take $50 with a Big Mac dude, literally.
The best route to take is to tear gas him.
The man shakes off the tear gas with almost superhuman strength.
Spray him with a fire hose.
Hoping that he will lose his grip on the sword. When that doesn't work, they turn the water pressure up, full blast.
And then pin him down with a ladder.
Those guys went down by the book.
Bro, this is not real, bro. This cannot be real. This dead ass cannot be real, bro.
A sword.
They threw tear gas at bro, and that nigga dead ass consumed all of it. I would have looked at that nigga kind of weird, bro, because tear gas. And then they tried to fucking use a fire hose on the nigga, and he just walks it off with Neosporin and a Band-Aid.
When that doesn't work, they turn the water pressure up. Full blast.
And then pin him down with a ladder.
And they pinned him down with a ladder. This,
those guys went down by the book. Exactly what they were supposed to do.
Oh, yeah, of course. I'm pretty sure this is the definition of by the book, actually. Now, when you look at this from the outside, who is in the wrong here?
Guns with special bean bags that...
Bro looks like he's about to do a fucking 50v1 standoff, bro. Bro's about to squad wipe everybody. Bro's just chilling. Yo, he low-key got aura, bro. I'm not gonna lie. This nigga dead ass got aura, bro. But really, bro?
Strike with the same impact as a heavyweight boxer's punch.
Chemical agents, or tear gas, makes the suspect very uncomfortable. Burns his eyes, burns his skin, and it makes it difficult for him to breathe.
The jets of water pack the force of a hurricane wind. Then, in a highly orchestrated maneuver, police pin the suspect down with a ladder, pole, and riot shield.
By the book, exactly what they were supposed to do.
With a ladder, pole.
Like, I thought they were kidding, bro. But these niggas' fucking course of action
and
was to deadass pin this nigga down with a fucking ladder. What? Other niggas doing galaxy gas, but he doing tear gas.
By the book.
Yo.
Exactly what they were
y'all niggas are funny.
Yeah, I agree. I don't know. You guys don't want it on my...
Hold up. What did that say?
Yeah, I agree.
I don't know. But except for some bruises suffered by the disturbed man, Tony Allison, 41, there were no injuries. Said the fact that he was still alive, showed he... Okay.
No, you guys don't want to know my opinion. What do you guys think? Would you consider this excessive force?
Hell yeah, that's just excessive force, bro.
This man's had enough. But the tragedy of they doing the most. Apollo Allison's story is not done. As it turns out, only a year prior to the sword incident, Tony Apollo Allison was released from Western State Hospital after finishing a 10-year sentence from a charge in which he pled not guilty due to insanity, a charge of second-degree assault with intent to... Before this incident, he was an alcoholic, wandering the streets with a sword on his back, and now he's a man with his name engraved in history. He was later sent back to Western State Hospital. However, his current whereabouts are unknown. Until now, in list of events, I think...
Damn, bro, I literally was gonna look that shit up, bro, like...
...are unknown. Until now, in a twist of events...
Parent outraged homeless camp next to son's school.
I think I might have just found him, or at least some potential evidence he's still out protecting the city. Back in 2021, a dad was with his son at Bitter Lake Playfield, and while passing by a homeless encampment, spotted this distinct shiny object sticking out of the debris. Now, the location of this park happens to be about 50 miles away from Western State Hospital, or a mere 8.2 miles away from where this whole thing began.
Yo, but niggas is detectives, bro. There's no way you sat here and analyzed the sword placement, where it was at, and then traced it back to the fucking hospital, and then traced it back to where everything began. Like, there's no way someone actually did that.
Now, due to Apollo's story being very old, and many news sources doing very minuscule amounts of deep diving, and just very little information in general, I had to resort to these two blog posts excessively. This one's got a really neat website, so go check it out.
It's got a lot of neat posts about, like, alien CIA project cover-up stuff.
What's good, Dad? Yeah,
don't
loss.
Forget to subscribe.
In the past few years, there have been many...
Bro said, the hero we didn't deserve, but need, is still out there. That was actually a W... See, I like random-ass videos like that, bro. That was a W video, bro.